I guess what always strikes me is that because something's not my problem, then it's not a problem. Unfortunately, the human race does not always seem to share that view. We can speak of Aborigines, the Native American, or the Tibetan. Whose family are they? They're ours. The separateness has been drummed into us. We are not separate. We are in all senses one. Any other notion leads to elitism, the chosen ones, and racism, fascism. At the end of the day, we make one simple choice. Love and peace, or hate and war. Peace follows love. War follows hate. And following on from these thoughts is also a relationship with the earth. Again, we have been taught that the earth is ours to take what we desire to access every single day. Part of this conditioning is within our culture, part within our religions, and part, most definitely, within our self-interest and greed, as it grows and is fed by raging consumerism of business. We see animals as game, zoo fodder. We see nature as wasted space. Yet, in all our hearts, we have this need to feel nature around us. Some, more as time goes by, have been raised under artificial light and forget their life, have no self-awareness beyond what can be bought, fought, or mated with. Kind of the most primitive parts of their hindbrains are in control. If a square mile of earth is polluted, that should hurt us all. But it doesn't. It doesn't. That's the separateness we've been taught in action. When another acre of forest goes down, we should all grieve for the loss. Despite claims, this is not a renewable energy source in the way they would have us believe. When the polar ice cap melts, we should feel that. We should be alarmed and saddened that they have to helicopter polar bears further north. From the very small, a nature reserve in your local area having a road put through it, to the ozone depletion levels, from the inactions of local leaders to the inactions of world leaders, all of this should matter. But they have taught us so very well to be concerned with only ourselves. Keep the population too tired to think straight, keep them in debt, enough not to stop and wonder where their life is going. Give them enough shiny objects to be bought, give them small things to keep them from asking questions. Okay, perhaps I am a nutcase, but can anyone tell me how they expect us to carry on like this for another 100 years? The UK is now going to go nuclear powered again. Why? Well, our own resources are all but gone. Gone, as in never coming back. As for the polar ice caps, remember, you can't make that a safari park or an area of special interest. What we do here, the energy we burn, the stuff we buy, what we consume has an impact on the top of the world. Isn't it hard for us to understand this? Isn't it going to be so very hard to change? What happens if we can't or won't? Well, I'm just a nutcase on the very fringe of society. Someone who loves trees and watching birds fly. And I don't have the intelligence to work that all out. Or do I?